Commander Hancock reporting, sir.
Ah, come in, Hancock. You know why I've sent for you.
I can guess, sir. P-64?
P-64 it is. According to specifications, it should top well over 2,000 miles an hour.
Jolly good chap.
Now, quite frankly, no one knows exactly what will happen when you get up there. All we know is that at that speed, metal does peculiar things. Once you've gone through the heat barrier, metal can melt into jelly.
What flavor?
Same old Hancock. Does nothing frighten you?
Nothing in the air, sir.
Well, now, here's a scale model. Here's a scale model of the aircraft. As you can see, the design is quite revolutionary. No wings, vertical takeoff. You lie flat on your stomach in the cockpit, and you'll notice it's approximately half the size of anything else we have.
I'm a bit worried about that, sir.
Ah, so you are human after all. What's worrying you, eh?
There'll be enough room for my moustache.
You're a cool customer. No different now as you were when you destroyed the German Air Force in 43.
Little older, sir?
Good luck, Hancock. England is proud of you. It's in the hangar waiting for you. Everything depends on you.
If anything should go wrong, sir, promise me I...
Anything, Hancock.
Don't abandon the project, sir. Keep them flying. Melt all my medals down and build another one. There are plenty of other good chaps waiting to have a crack. Goodbye, sir.
Goodbye, Hancock. Sergeant James.
Yep.
Show Wing Commander Hancock to his plane.
Yep. Don't forget it's a vertical takeoff, sir.
I know. Don't bother to open the hangar door. I'll go out to the fan line.
H for Hancock calling control tower. Leveling out at 1,800 miles per hour. Everything going to plan. Fine plane, tell the designer Chappie.
Control tower to Hancock. We're worried about possible sabotage. The mechanic who was working on your aircraft is missing. Think you should come down. Land immediately. Repeat, land immediately.
Nonsense, she's going beautifully. I don't know a thing about any mechanic. Taking her up to 2,400 miles an hour. Hancock to control tower. Something strange is happening. There's a peculiar knocking sound on the windscreen. Seems to be coming from outside the plane. I'm slowing down to 1,800 miles an hour. We'll slide cockpit open to see what's wrong.
Good evening.
It's an awful cold out here, can I tell you?
What's that?
I say an awful cold out here, can I come in?
There's no room, get off!
Oh, don't be like that. Move over, I'll sit on your lap.
Get your boot off me joystick, feel nice. Who are you?
Me? I'm the mechanic. I was still working on the tower when you took off. Honestly, frightened the life out of me. I mean, I wasn't expecting it. I was just sitting there singing happily to myself, and then next minute, whoosh, I was up here.
Sit still. I can't control the plane with you jumping about.
Well, I'm only trying to get comfortable. All these knobs and levers here sticking in me. Here, what's this one?
Don't touch it!
Oh, it's the ejector seat. Come back. Where are you?
I'm out here sitting on the tail.
Well, now, stop messing about. No, come back in. It's no use sitting out there sulking. I can't drive the thing.
Well, go into a dive so I can slide down.
All right. I'll try this lever. Hello? You might have told me there was another ejector seat.
All right, well, we're both out here. Now what do we do?
Oh, look, we're going up.
Well, what do you expect when we're both sitting on the tail?
Isn't life funny? In the papers this morning, the Star said it was my lucky day.
If we keep going up at this rate, you'll be able to tell them they're wrong.
No, well, come on, we've had a little skylark and a little giggle. Let's go down.
How can we go down? Look, we've finished the engines falling off.
Oh, it's all right. They've got plenty more down there.
We want one up here. We're going into a dive. We're out of control. We can't get back to the cabin. Give me a piece of string.
Oh, I'm scared. Oh.
Don't panic, man. Don't panic. This is the RAF. Where's that stiff upper lip?
It's above this loose, flabby chin.
Give me that string. I'll get you down safely.
How did you manage it, sitting on the tail like that?
Quite simple. I took a piece of string, lassoed the controls, and steered it home. Lucky I was a cox at Oxford, eh?
Ah, brilliant work, Hancock. You've won another medal. You'll go down in history as the most courageous and most decorated pilot in the RAF.
Well, that's it for this side. You better take the needle off now, otherwise it'll hit that metal bit that sticks up through the hole in the middle. Never used to have that trouble with the cylinders. Never had to turn them over, either. All on the same side. Progress? God, dear. Well, go on, turn it over.